make it. So I, Sonya Blade, has joined you today, as along with Johnny, of course. He has his trophy here. We got just the regular old fam, or is it Kenji? That's a good question. But he also has the nunchucks. He's doing a little mix. We got Melina. We got some Mortal Kombat guy over there, and then we got some other Mortal Kombat guy. Hello, Jeff. Thank you for joining. He does look ready for action, doesn't he? He's got his weapons. So cute. It's good. Alright guys, so like I said, we got the ultimate Mortal Kombat workout today. But of course, like always, we need to warm up. So we're gonna do like some, what I would think would be a combatant's warm-up routine, okay? And the reasons I think this, you know, it's up for interpretation. You can ask if you're wondering why I thought this would be. But then after that, then we're gonna do a workout. There's a bunch of moves inspired by or taken directly from Mortal Kombat. And then for the cooldown, of course, we gotta do some flexibility because a lot of them characters are really, really flexible. Especially like we're gonna do Johnny Cage's middle split. We're gonna do some side split practice. Of course, it's not necessary you need to be able to do all these things. We're working towards them, you know what I mean? Alright, so let's get going with the warm-up. Get ready wherever you're at. Get ready. So we're going to start with just a little bit of mobility circle, as I call it. Thank you for the follow, Chris. Hope you're having a good day. Alright, so we're just going to start here. Hands on hip. We're just going to do a big circle with our hip because, you know, it's going to move the hip. Hi, Alan. I'm doing good, thank you. How are you? Thanks for being here. Alright, and then the other way. I gotta pull my pants up. Kind of falling down. Maybe I need to just do that. There we go. Thank you, Popularity. You're kind. Thank you for joining. Hope you're having a wonderful, wonderful day. Alright, really good. So now, you're gonna stand like this. Nice, wide stance. Then what we're gonna do is we're gonna bring one arm up and over. Stretch to the side. Look up if you can. Like that. Then you're gonna turn your body down towards the ground. See how far down towards the ground you can get your hands. And then what we're gonna do now is we're gonna bend the back knee while we keep the front leg as straight as possible. If you need to hold on to something that's like higher up, like this, do that, whatever works for you. So you're just gonna go down and up and down and up and just a couple more times just to get that hip and leg moving here. Really, really good. Alright, then you move your hands into the middle. Yoga, this will be awesome to work up the appetite. Hell yeah. This is more mobility, I'd say, than yoga, but I see the idea is there. Okay, now you bend your legs and straight. And bend and straight. Whew. Just go as far down as you can so you feel a little bit of a stretch in your hips. All right, now you stay down. You bring your hands onto your knees and you push out. It's feeling good stretch through your hips. And then if you want to, then you dip one shoulder down and then the other, just back and forth. Back and forth. Very good. All right, now you straighten. You go to the side that you just looked. You know what I mean? Not the other side. The side you just looked. And you turn your foot over so that you're on your toes. Hansy, I'm sorry. I'm kind of on you here. And then now, same thing as before. You have a bent front leg. You try to straighten it as much as you can. And bend. And straighten. Just keep going a couple times. Beyonce, don't kick me yet. Please don't. Don't use your nunchucks to kill me, please. That wouldn't be very nice. It's quite the bear, you know. Quite the bear. Okay, now just stand here for just a second. Nice big stretch in your leg. And then pick yourself up. Good job. You did it. Now to the other side. Same thing. So, here. You're doing great. Flip. You got it. Other hand on hip. Arm goes up and over. Nice big stretch. Really good. Both hands as far down to the ground as possible. Remember, you can hold on to a wall or something if you need to, if it's too much to go all the way down. And then you bend the back leg and straighten just a couple times. You're doing amazing. You're becoming a combatant for every second. Every second that goes by, you have a greater chance at winning Mortal Kombat. Which is great. That's what we're here for, right? Okay, one more. There we go. Now you move into the middle. Like so. Burn the butt. That's great. And then once again, you bend and straighten. And bend and straighten. Just a couple. Really, really good. Now you keep your legs bent. Push out. Should be a little bit easier now since you've done it once. Maybe, hopefully. If you want to, you dip one shoulder at a time. Back and forth. You're doing amazing. Really good. Okay, then you move over to the side you just were. Turn your back leg. And then you try to straighten that front leg as much as possible. And then bend. Just a couple times. You got it. Now just keep it as straight as possible. And then pick yourself up. Well done. You're doing great. You're doing great. Whew. Okay. So now for the next thing. Hi, Jason. Let's go. GG's. GG's. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Yes, everyone's doing amazing. Is that what that stands for? Good work? Hell yeah. This is it. You're doing great, guys. Still with you. That's good, Flip. That's good. Trust me, it'll get hard. I think some of these exercises are going to be quite hard because, like I said, Mortal Kombat, not an easy game to follow. But it's going to be fun. That's all that matters. Don't worry. We're taking it easy. We're easing up to it, Flip. Don't worry. Okay, next one, we got to just... Because we know they do a lot of kicking in Mortal Kombat, so we gotta like warm up our hips and our legs to do some kicking, okay? So we're just gonna have our hands on our hips or whatever you wanna have them, and then we're just gonna do a nice big circle with our knee like that. So one, and two, and three. Will you do a shadow kick through that wall? That'd be awesome. five, and six, and now we're gonna do the same thing, but we're gonna try to see how much you can straighten your leg in the swing. It doesn't have to be really high, remember that. You can go really low, you can go lower than you want to, or than your body can do if you want to, just to get warmed up, remember. But you, what we do is we swing the same, but you swing with a straight leg, like that. And watch out for hitting anything around you. You're 100 years old? I don't know about that. I don't believe you, Flip. Three. You're doing great. Four. Five. And six. Good job. Other leg. So, first with a bent knee. One. Two. Three. Sorry. Four. Five and six. Good job. Now big circle. Here we go. One, two, three, four, five, and six. Good job. I know where I would like to put my size 47. What? Your size 47? What does that mean? See my big boy sub singer? Yeah, I move all the way across the wall. I got prime real estate now. Yeah, you do. There you are, FL. Right? You're the one pointing to this shark. You're like this with the shark. My feet are, oh, I see. I hope it doesn't hit your TV or anything. That'd be bad. All right, really good job with that. Now we're gonna do some foot rolls. So here you're gonna lift up, hold your balance. Just gonna roll our feet. You kicked a picture off the wall by accident? Oh no! Katie, I hope it didn't smash. I used to look like Bamzo's earring. Yeah. Yeah, I'm taking that to be, try jewels is now Bamzo's earring, or almost. Hello, Grim. Hope you're doing well. Thank you. All these people want me to remove the socks. You know, Sonya Blade wears white shoes in the game. That's why I wore a white sock to represent. All right, good job. Other leg. Big circle. Oh, my foot is cracking. And then the other way. Don't remove socks. I don't plan on it. Really good job. It wasn't glass, thank you. That's good, that's good. There's a lot, like Sean, that's not only about a costume. Well, I appreciate that.
Wow.
Yes, I would love only to play
Sophia Stunts,
you know,
could
I would.
Pull off a move like that.
Hell yeah. Thank you, Phil. Thank you. Okay, really good job. Now, hands together. Around! That's right. Okay, hands together. Roll them around. It's kind of hard with these on, honestly. They tend to, like, go into my hand. Okay, there we go. Hi, Stel. It's going good. How are you doing? And then the other way. It's a little bit harder the other way. Be strong, Mila. Thank you so much for the follow. Hope you have a good day. All right. Is this your commando look? No, it's my Sonya Blade look. Sonya Blade from Mortal Kombat 1. All right. Really good job. Bigger Arna, hope you have a good day. Okay, now let's just warm up our shoulders a bit too, because we're gonna be punching a bit. So you're gonna be here. Good afternoon, Big Arna. Hope you did good. From Germany, that's awesome. So big circles with your shoulder. Gotta get ready for all the punching we're gonna do. To Kano. Kano needs some punches, you know. You see it now? That's good. My wrist cracked more than my feet. Wow. Well, yeah, we're all different in that regard. Okay, good job. You also use the outfit when you hit men. I mean, I could. Perfect pronunciation of my name. Very impressive. Well, I am Danish, so Arne is in Danish. It's the blood. Thank you for the love. Here we go. Yeah. All right, last little thing for the warm up. Not a very long warm up today. Just a little neck stretch here. So you grab a hold, pull a little bit, and push your shoulder away from you. Feel the stretch. Very good. Roll to the other side. Same thing. You push away. Shania MK1, caution with MK3 hair. She has this hair in MK1 as well, I swear. She does. In the new one, at least, she has like a strand of hair, you know, going like this. Hers is just a little bit shorter than mine. Right? Right. And, oh yeah, for the workout, you might, you can do everything without, like, weights or anything, but if you have like some hand weights or just something that you can hold in your hand that weighs a little bit, it would be it would make it better. I'm gonna be using these just because I can. It could be heavier than this. These aren't that heavy, but it just, you know, for the look. But yeah, if you have hand weights or something like that, feel free to use that. You also not. A lot of reasons you can use them. It can be anywhere as well in the body. All right, let's get going with the Mortal Kombat workout. This is gonna be great. It's gonna be a lot of fun, I think. All of this.
Time to play the game.
All of this, like I mentioned, are taken from Mortal Kombat. Or things that I think Mortal Kombat combatants from the game would be doing when they are working out. And we're gonna start out really easy with probably the only one I feel like isn't directly taken from the game, which is jumping jacks. We're gonna do 20 jumping jacks, nice and calmly, just to get everything going. So here we go, get ready. Remember, you can always do an easier version where you just step out, or you can jump with me. So here we go. 3, 2, 1. 1, 2, 3. Jumping jacks, hell yeah! 5, 7, I think. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20 is the jumping jacks. We need to have robot arms. All right, next exercise is the squat blocks. And what does that mean? It's basically, we're gonna do it twice, once to both sides, or 10 times to both sides. So you're gonna do, in Mortal Kombat, you know, you can squat and block. And that's usually the first thing I do when I play the game, in case they come at me with something, you know? So you're gonna go in a squat like this, and you're gonna block something that's coming from over here, okay? Kick, a punch, anything. Fair, blood, fair. All right, so here we go. We're gonna go down. 1, block it. 2, 3, 4. Keep going, you got it. 6, it's for your life, this. 7, 8, 9, and 10. And now they're over there, they jumped over you. They're coming from over there, same thing. 1, this keeps going. Gotta do the kick from the squat position. Always a funny move in the game. Yeah. Don't worry, it's on here. It's on here. There's something that is similar. Okay, now next one. You know, first thing I always do in the game is block and then jump. Because you don't want to get hit down here either, you know? So we're gonna do some jump dodges. Basically, what I want you to do, these are hard, okay? You're gonna jump up, bring your knees up as high as you possibly can. Because you need to make as much space between you and the floor. So someone's throwing something at you there, and they're throwing something at you from there, and we're gonna just alternate up until we've done it 10 times, okay? So here, we jump. One, left, whoop, two, block, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Good job. Good when Raiden is flying at you, blocking him if he's low, but he'll probably go over your head and bash into the side of the screen, yeah. Definitely. Ghost, thank you for joining. You'd fall through my floor. Don't do it then. I'm getting exhausted by just looking. It's hard. Trust me. Okay, good job. Whew. Next exercise, we pick up our weights. And I, of course, have my my size. So the next exercise is the classic punch, you know? Classic punch, nothing crazy, but with weights in our hands. So you're gonna punch forward, just, you know, cross and cross. We're gonna do that 20 times. And you remember, you choose how much weight you have in your hands. The more, obviously, is gonna get harder. So, I'll be down for MK. / Street Fighter crossover. That would be really fun. I would like that. Okay, here we go. So 3, 2, 1. Punch and punch. That's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. And 20, a really good job. Now, keep your weight. Same thing, no, not same thing, same weight. you're gonna use your diaphragm weight, that's cute. Oh, we gotta hydrate, okay. Let's just get the hydrate before we do this one. Rap Terry, springy, cute. Okay, so. You have your weights in your hands. You actually only need one in one hand, but it's up to you if you want to keep the other one. We're going to do some uppercuts. I think I'm going to do it like this. Looks better. So we're going to do some uppercuts, and I want you to be like sideways like this. You're going to go all the way down into a lunge. You're going to bring your in, and then all the way up, okay? Really want to strike them all the way up. We're going to do 10 on each side. Here we go. So here we go, down, up, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Good job. Other leg, those are sick weapons, aren't they? I love these, they're so cool. Jab cross, love it, they're good. Okay, other leg, side, sorry. So here, get your side out, there we go. And we go down and up, that's one, keep going. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, You're doing amazing. All right, now we've come to one. It's a little bit more specific. It's Lee May from Mortal Kombat 1. She throws a lantern into the air that I've been hit by too many times. Let me tell you. Basically what she does, you still have your weights in your hand. She throws it up like that. Literally just what she does. She just throws it up like that. But trust me, it's gonna be hard with the weights in your hand to keep doing that motion. So we're gonna do 10 on each side. So you throw and up. So one, two, see if you can have a completely straight arm all the way. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Now someone's gonna walk into that and they're not gonna be very happy about it. All right, other arm. So here, you throw and pull it down. Throw, bring it down. Two, keep going. Three, four, five, six, you got it, feel it. Seven, kill those people with your lantern. Nine, last one, and 10, there we go. Good job, good job. All right, next one, it's really fun. I call it the get over here. Because, you feel it, that's gameplay, that's awesome. Because what we're gonna be doing is basically, what is up? Shy Dia, Dija, how are you doing? Well, so, you know, Scorpion has a very famous line that is, get over here. And what he does when he says that is he throws his spear chain thing. I actually don't know what the name of it is. Scorpion. We're going scorpion with this one. And she throws the thing to pull someone closer, basically. Get over here. So what we're gonna do, one leg in front of the other, weight in your hand, you're gonna throw it forward as far as you can, and then pull them in. Okay? You throw and pull. Do 10 of those. Here we go. Throw and pull. That's one. Two. Three. Get over here. Four. Five. Yell it out. Get over here. Six, I think. Seven. Eight. You got it. Nine. Get over here. 10. Gotcha. And then uppercut. We've already done those. It's called a kunai spear. Oh, it is? Okay, that's an awesome name. I like the name. But I actually didn't know that. I've never even thought of what it was called. So, other leg in front now. We're throwing it. Throwing it, okay? Maybe I could turn the other way so you can see my face from all this hair. So here, you're throwing and down. That's one. Keep going. Get over here. Two. Three. Four. Five. Really extend that arm. Six. Get over here. Seven. I can't help myself. It's just such a good line. Eight. Nine. Last one, and 10, good job. But don't actually throw it. Yeah, don't actually throw it. Especially if there's like TVs and stuff. Not great, not great. All right, put down your weights. You did great. Shirky, you hold on to these, okay? Here you go. He is Melina today, after all. Well done, yes, good job. You messed up. You threw it. Don't throw it. It's a bad idea. Yay, thank you for the clip. Real quick, how do I repair a hole in my wall? I don't have the knowledge on that. I think you're gonna gonna have to figure that one out for yourself. You figure it out after the fourth round. Hey, that's why we're here. We're here to learn. Don't worry. All right, so next one is a first kick exercise. Put a poster over it. That is smart. Yes. So we're basically gonna be in a nice lunge here. So you're gonna lunge down, and then you're gonna put your weight on your front leg to then kick, do a front kick forward. It doesn't have to be high. You can kick very low. You can kick, you can touch the ground if you want. Completely up to you. As long as we put our weight on and kick forward in some way, okay? So we're gonna do 10 of those. Here we go. So you lunge, you kick. That's one, keep going. Two, three, four, you got it, five, six, seven, eight, nine, feel the burn, and 10, good job. You put your front kick in, you put your front kick out. You gotta hit your TV with those beers. I try not to, you know. Hello, the red dragon, I'm having a good day. You might actually be able to kick me in the face. I think I would be. No way, I sometimes do this when I'm wearing up to do more Muay Thai front kick. Yeah, this is, a lot of these are very Muay Thai similar. But like, you know, a lot of martial arts have similarities in that sense. Okay, so other leg. So here, you lunge. So I need to point that way so I don't kick the wall. And kick. Good job. And again, kick. That's two. Keep going. Try to keep your balance. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine and 10. Really good job. Well done. Okay. Good job. Now comes the time for those floor kicks I was talking about. So basically, you're going to be blocking someone. They're over there. You're blocking them in a squat. Then what you're going to do, put your hands beside you. They're over there, so you're gonna kick them there. You put your knee down, you kick them to the side, and then you go back up. It's a nice little functional exercise. Yes, your taekwondo is quite impressive, Drew. Thank you, appreciate it. The best lesson here is how you can fully exercise yourself with a minimum space. Exactly. Very well said. All right, so here we go. You're in your squat, you're blocking, put your hands down, kick, bring it up. That's one, keep going. Two. Three. If you can't get all the way up to a squat position like this, again, don't worry, just go as far as you can. Five, I think. Six. Seven, eight, nine, and 10. Really good job. Woo. My ass on fire. And I want to hear I don't have room to work out from anyone ever again. Same. It's not valid. There's a lot of other reasons you can't work out, but not having space is not valid. Do you live alone? I do. You've not been in Muay Thai for ages. I've never done Muay Thai, but it looks really fun. Seeing your crescent kick and question mark kick is what made me follow your IG. That's awesome, thank you. Yeah, those are really fun kicks. Cabrera workout, Mortal Kombat workout. All right, other side. So you're in your squat, you're blocking, you put your knee down, you kick. I don't want this. That was, okay, here we go. So we're gonna start now. You're in there. One. Two. I'm stepping on this. One moment. 3, 4. Feel the burn in your leg. 5, 6, 7, 8. 2 more. 9. And 10. Whew! That's a burn, isn't it? For a pad thai. Pad thai is pretty good. How old are you? Between the age of 20 and 25. Starburst, thank you for the follow. Oh, if you've ever been to war, you prefer not to fight. Yeah, I can imagine. Can imagine. Really good job. Really good job. Grab some water. You're laying on the floor. You're doing great, Johnny. He can't take that many kicks, no. Trust me, he'll kick back. He's a kicker and a puncher with his nunchucks. So cute. Wah! Wah! Damn it. These are like made of plastic, so they're not great. He has always been here on Instagram. Thanks for sharing the link to Twitch. Of course, thank you, Service Girl. It's a pleasure to have you here. Thank you for joining. So many hugs. Oh, my headband's coming loose. The floor feels comfy. It is a great place. You want some cool nunchucks? Go get some. I mean, they can be expensive depending on what kind you buy, but there are definitely some cheap ones out there. All right, really good job. Here, now next exercise is knee switches. So, what we're gonna do is we're gonna pull up a nice knee. You're giving someone a knee. And then I want you, as you put your foot down, you shimmy the back leg back, and then you pull it up to a knee, and then you jump out, pull it up. Keep going like that, okay? We're gonna do 12 of these. Feel free to do it nice and slowly or faster if you can. So you pull it up, switch, pull your hip forward. I'm kind of forgetting it, sorry. Oh, I messed up. I haven't been counting. How many are we at? I think that's 8. Let's say that's 8. 9, 10, 11, and 12. There we go. Good job. Got shot by, he took it like a bear. He did, he's wounded. Not anymore. He's a strong bear now. Strong bear. All right, really, really good job. Now, I want you to find a wall or anything that you can hold on to. But please, like, if it's a chair, make sure it's not gonna fall if you put too much weight into it, okay? I mean, yummy. Appreciate it. This is a legit technique, especially if you get your hands behind someone's head. Yeah, it's a... Give it a lot of knees very fast. Martial arts, yep. Doing Mortal Kombat. Boot, strap, thank you for the fall. Took me 3 tries to get the rhythm. It is hard. Especially in here for me, is I feel like I keep moving forward, so I keep trying to like jump back. It is the best outfit ever, isn't it? I love it. All right, let's do some side kicks. You're gonna find a wall, hold on to it with your hand, then you're gonna, the leg you're standing on is the one that's closest to the wall. So you wanna turn that one slightly outward, so it's diagonally out. It's best for you, best for your hips, best for everything. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna pull your leg in to a chamber like this. And you're basically gonna bring your knee up as high as you possibly can. Of course, don't overdo it. We don't want injuries, but just pull it up as high as you can. Keep your foot flexed. And then now you straighten and bend. And straighten and bend. Keep going, that's two. Three. Four. Five. You got it. Six. Four more. Seven. Eight. Nine. And ten. Really good job. Woo. Shake your leg. You fall down, it's a part of it. Trust me, learning to kick, you're gonna fall a lot of times. It's a part of it. It's like a darker version of MK2 song and design. I could see that. It is supposed to be MK1, but it does look darker. It is darker, definitely. It should be a lot lighter. I think when I stand here, it looks a lot darker. When I walk into the light, it gets easier to see the color, at least. Glad you have high ceilings being 6'3". Yeah, important with the kicking. All right, good job. Other leg. So you bring your hand onto a wall again. Turn your foot slightly up. Chamber, 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 chamber. Then you kick. Bring it in. It's one. Keep going. I did so much kicking yesterday. My hips are on fire. Three. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and ten. Really good job. The underwear in my pants, that's what you wear. So yeah, so it is. It's Mortal Kombat, Sonya Blade. She wears underwear over her pants for some reason. But it looks cool, that's why. I love it. Okay, really good job. Now, when I kick, it's mostly ass. Mm-hmm. It really works the ass. in a good way. Okay, so, next one. Superman is the same, he is. A lot of superheroes, actually. There's a lot of people out there, superheroes and characters that wear underwear over the pants. It just gives something, you know? Thank you for the follow. Good afternoon, no space, no time. Hope you're doing good. All right, now you go back to we're still holding onto the wall. The first leg this time. Now we're gonna do triple kicks. We're only gonna do six. And what I mean by triple kicks is you're gonna kick very low and you're gonna kick halfway to your maximum, and you're gonna kick your maximum, okay? And whatever if your maximum is here, then you kick one, two, three. You see? Don't go crazy, you know, we're all learning. It's about learning, not about being good at it from the start, remember. And then you can go higher and higher the more you practice. Called overwear, yes. Well, thank you. Appreciate the follow. It's crazy to think there's two MK games now you can refer to as MK1. It is weird, isn't it? But yeah, well, I never paid attention to the underwear over the pants. Oh no. Yeah, now you're gonna see it everywhere, Johnny. All right, so here we go. We're gonna do six of those. So you kick, kick, kick. That's one. Keep going. Kick, kick, kick. Two, kick, kick, three, kick, 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 four, kick, 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 five, last one, six, really good job. Other leg, same thing. Even Rollerine does it for most costumes, he does. A lot of superheroes wear underwear over their clothes. It is very hard. I know. It's really hard, a lot of these. Especially if you've never done any martial arts before. It's really difficult. But I'm very happy you're trying, and there's only one way to learn, and it's to try. And, of course, these exercises aren't easy, but all of them are like, I try to pick exercises that no matter what level you're on, or no matter how flexible you are, you'll get something out of it. So, here we go. Other leg. So you kick, you kick, you kick. That's one, keep going. And kick. Two, keep going. Sonia would be such a kind and thoughtful martial arts instructor. You know, I surprise many people. Sure, yeah, Jerky. Give me a hug. Aww, what a cute boy. Mwah. Oh, he's so cute. Holding the wall is cheating, but it's not. It makes it so that it's less about balance and more about the leg strength. If you want to make it about balance, then you stand out in the open, you know? Okay, so what you're going to do is you're going to have your hands on the ground like this, sideways. It's a miniature version of a cartwheel because a lot of them do cartwheels in this game. I don't know if you've noticed. You're going to have it like this. If I have my left foot in front, then I have a left hand beside it, right hand across from it, okay? Then I'm gonna bring the back leg up, jump over to the other side, like this. Make sense? You're gonna do it the other way. You're gonna jump and go over. And if you're feeling really like that's way too hard, then you're gonna stand like this, you're gonna have one leg up, and you're gonna switch and switch, okay? That's a little bit easier. It's a little bit easier. But if you wanna follow me, you come into the first position here. We're gonna do 10. So here we go. You're gonna swing and jump. That's one. Keep going. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. And 10. Really good job. No joke, never had any concept of how to do a cartwheel. This exercise is a great start. Cause like, most people can do this. Most people can do that. And that's the motion of a cartwheel. There's not more to it. All you have to do to do an actual cartwheel is just swing this leg a bit higher. And then you're there. To be fair, I've always been pretty large human, so agility is my strong suit, obviously. All right, good job with that. You know, anything with my hands in the ground is kind of painful because of these. Let me just bring them up a little bit. All right, really good job. So, next one is a wall handstand, because like in Mortal Kombat, there's a lot of people who do handstands and similar things to it. So, if you don't want to do a handstand, don't worry, you can do a regular plank. And I want you to do it like this, where your hands are in like this, and you put your weight a little bit over and then hold it, okay? Hold it 30 seconds. We're gonna do this together, so just wait. But if you wanna follow me, you put your butt towards the wall. You put your hands into the ground in front of you. You bring your foot onto the wall. You bring your other foot onto the wall. You either stay here or you move in towards the wall. High handsy. Then we hold it 30 seconds. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Thank you for the fall. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, and 30. Slowly come back down. You did great. Well done. Planks. Test your resolve. Heavy. The longer you do it. Yeah, it gets really hard. Ooh, let's go, Casey. Do that. Yeah, if you have space enough and you want to try it, you can also try to do it just a regular handstand out in the open. You're very welcome to do that. Whew, really good job, guys. Grab some water. You're doing absolutely amazing. Now it's time for balance, indeed. All right, here we go. So, first one is the classic yoga tree pose. A very good beginner exercise for balance training. I want you to have one leg pointing, like if you're standing forward like this, one leg is pointing slightly outward. Then you're gonna, if you need to, hold onto a wall to begin with. If you can, then you just stay here. Then you're gonna bring your leg up as far as you can. If you can, you grab it and put it all the way up on your thigh, but don't worry if it's further down on your leg, completely fine. Have your hands like this. We hold it 15 seconds. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Good job. Slowly put your leg down. Fainting gives me a great rest. That is a good point. And you're well rested afterwards. All right, other leg. So, other leg comes up. Put it on your thigh if possible. Hands come to prayer. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Really good job. Bring your leg down slowly and calmly. Good job. Next exercise is the Y pose. Love the Y pose. Great for flexibility, great for balance, a lot of things. I recommend if you're new to just start with your hand on the wall, and once you've figured out the movement of it, then you can try to start taking it off. But start with your hand on the wall. So if you're new to this, the Y pose is basically where you have your leg up in the air and you're holding on to it to kind of create a Y shape. So if you're new, I recommend you grab your toes like this. She's 100% making this look easier than it really is. Yep, I tend to do that. And I'm sorry about that. I've just done a lot of this in my life. So, you know, I tend to be good at it. Okay, so if you're new, I recommend you hold on to your toes like this. So that, because this makes it a little bit easier to stand up straight and pull your feet in. So the idea is you want to try to stand up as straight as you can. Just start with that. Thank you. That's human sidekick. And then also, at the same time, trying to see how much you can straighten your leg. And don't worry if you can't straighten your leg all the way, you can't stand up all the way. Just take your time, whatever you can do. Practice it a little bit on your own. But if you can, then you straighten and lift up and see how far you can go up like this. And if you can, take your hand off the wall, hold your balance. But if you're a little bit more advanced, I want you to try to hold your hand around your heel and then do the same thing. In my opinion, it just looks prettier. It's just nicer to look at, a little bit harder as well. And then we just hold it, 10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good job. Well done. Let's do the other leg. Same thing, let's warm up to it first. Get the eye, use some of the force. Yeah, don't worry if you can't go as high, guys. Please remember, you're at your own level. You go as high as you can. They would have snapped. Oh no, spring. Oh no. My leg would break off like a drumstick. No, guys, you're gonna be fine, I promise. I promise everyone, you're gonna be fine. Just take it easy. You don't have to go really high. So like I said before, start with grabbing your toes like this. Thank you for the follow. You're gonna try to lift up your body. like this. And then when you're down here, you're gonna try to straighten your leg as much as you can. You're doing great. And then if you can, you try to do both at the same time and pull it in if you can. And if you're a little bit more advanced, let's do the hand behind the heel version and bring it up. Just wanna get away from that. There we go. There we go. Whee! All right, awesome. Know why I'm more like an L? L is great. L is amazing. You're doing great. All right, so if you're in the L like Johnny, try it one more time to both sides. Blood, thank you for the sub. You're so kind.
Yeah.
You're gonna go on the wall. You're gonna go on the wall. Let me just write it down. Thank you. Oh, blood. Not only can Sophia hold her leg almost to her head, she can 1 foot shuffle along the ground while doing so. Yeah, I can. You gotta do the MCA. Oh, damn it. Okay, like I said, if you have a really hard time with that, I want you to try one more time to both sides. If you are a little bit more advanced and you've done this before, you've practiced this before, you're quite flexible, let's try to do an I pose, which is the same thing. It's just not a Y, it's an I. Completely straight, okay? So you're gonna bring that first leg, hold however you want. You're gonna pull your hip up first, that's what I like to do. And then once you're there, grab a hold of your leg, and now we're doing an I. I can't hold my balance. There we go. And then we smile. Good job. Other side. Other side. Remember, you're doing the Y if you had a hard time with it. Kumis is a hero outfit giving her abilities. That's why I'm always wearing a hero outfit. Okay, other side. So here, grab a hold. Pull your hip up first. Bring it up. Good job! So you could do double unders while doing the, as if she had tried the double unders. What's that? Dan Dano. Love it. Nice balance. Thank you. I'm Hathaway. Thank you for joining. Wait, nice outfit. Thank you. We love it. No fair. I can't do the bow and arrow. Hey, one day you can if you keep practicing. Can't do that move. It is really hard, guys. So don't worry if you can't do it. Okay, last balance. Last balance. Double unders is a skipping rope thing. Oh yeah, I can do those. I used to do, we had like a jump roping thing when I did dance. And I used to do like double jumps, just continually. It's really fun. Double unders. We call them double jumps, but same thing. Okay, so last one is the front balance. Once again, hold on to a wall to begin with. And you can slowly try. Take it off the more you do it, okay? Or the if you find it easier or something. You can either decide to hold onto your knee. If this is stretching for you, I recommend you do this and try to hold your balance, okay? See if you can hold your balance. 10 to 20 seconds. If you want to do a little bit harder version, you grab onto your foot again. Same way, opposite arm though. You straighten your leg and you pull up as high as you can. And you try to balance. So I can't count to the focus. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. What about the balls? What about them? We axe kick them, right? have such long legs, I don't know if I'd ever be able to do the stretch you just did. Hey, I mean, that is true that it's harder the longer the legs you have, but it definitely doesn't make it impossible. Definitely just gonna take some time, though, to learn. Okay, other leg. So you grab either the knee or the leg. You lift up. Hold your balance. Really good job. Well done, guys. Grab some water. You're doing amazing. We got a couple exercises on the ground and then the stretching. So, first exercise here on the ground. Best feeling when you see and feel the progress. It really is. Like, all that discipline, all those times where you didn't want to do it, but you did it anyways, it's finally showing itself. You know, it's such a nice feeling. Such a nice feeling. All right, first exercise is the frog. It's a balancing exercise. So if you've never done this before, it's a hand balancing exercise. Bring something soft in front of you, like a pillow or a lobster, it's up to you. Whichever one works for you, or a shark. And then, what you're gonna do, if you've been on my channel, you know this one. Both hands in the ground, knees outside of your arms like this, you're on your toes. Then you're gonna bend your elbows. It's a great start to a handstand if you wanna learn a handstand, because it's easier than a handstand. It teaches you balance. And you're gonna put your knees over your elbows. Gotta just put my hair back. And then you're gonna try to put your weight forward and pick your feet off the floor and then hold your balance. If you fall, you fall onto something soft. Okay, if you want to, you can do it without it, of course. So here, you bring it up. Try to see if you can hold it for 5 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And you bring it down. Just try it on your own to see if you can catch it. Hands is ready, always. It's a great pat in the back mentality. Yeah. That's so dope. Random realization of what you're capable of are almost always not. It's so good. It's such a great, you know? And especially because I've tried that move before and I just couldn't do it. My shoulder was way too locked. And I tried it maybe like 3 months ago or something and I couldn't do it. And then, you know, I just kept doing all my exercises, all my shoulder exercises and stuff like that. And I tried it again Thursday and I did it. And it's been working, you know, it's not for nothing. I'm doing these things. Okay, one more time. Let's hold it 5 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good job. Well done. Frog makes sense. It looks like a frog. I didn't know that was called the frog. Always called them teddy bear hands. That's also a great name. I don't think my name is the right one. I mean, I think there's a lot of different names for all these things. I just know it as the frog. Smelling the pleasure? Always, Alan. You know I love to do that. Miss you, lovely. Hope you've been well. I'm on the better end of some rough events. Looking good now, though. That's great to hear, Danny. I'm sorry. Sorry you've had some rough events, but it's good to see you again. I'm happy to hear you're on the good side of it now, okay? Thank you for joining again. All right, good job with that. Now you're gonna come onto your butt. Put both legs out to the side. You don't wanna be in a full split for this. Your legs are gonna cramp for that. So just a little nice wide sit. What do you call it? Nice wide with your legs. Why doesn't that make sense, what I'm saying? You want your legs to be nice and wide, just not really wide, okay? That's what I was trying to say. And then, what you're gonna do is you're either gonna have your hands behind you like this, or you have your hands like this. This is harder, okay? Behind here is easier, because then you can put your weight into your hands. If you have them here, it's harder because you need to use your legs more. So, here, hands wherever you want them, here or here. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna lift this leg up 8 times, okay? It can be really hard. If you start getting a cramp, stop. You can get a cramp in your hip flexor. masters for this one. And that's why I say do this if it's too hard. So here we go. 3, 2, 1. You lift. 1, 2, 3. Keep going. 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Really good job. Love watching you do the move just in case the name is different than what I'm used to. Yeah. It's always fun, you know? We learn different things. Know it from different places. Other leg. Good job. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Really good job. Well done. Those are hard. My knee is in support brace. Yeah. Would be hard. Even harder to do these then. Okay, really good job. Now, time you're gonna stay here and we're gonna do 8 butt lifts. So I want you to have your hands here. Wait, I can't do that with these. Never mind, what I meant was you're gonna have your hands here and we're gonna do butt lifts. So you're gonna be like this, you're gonna lift up your butt and bring it down. It's a weird move, but it's good. It's a good little break dancing move here. So we're gonna do 8. So you're gonna lift and put it down. 1, 2. Keep your legs straight. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Good job. Ba 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 ba. You're gonna go lay down, be fine. Not to mention you have shown me some variations. Yeah, a little thing to follow. Some variations that I have fallen in love. That's so great. I'm so happy so you guys can use what I show you. That's just so great. It's like, it makes me so happy that I can give something back to all of you for being here. What the heck is this exercise? It's a breakdancing exercise, you know?
To learn to lift your hips.
It does look weird. But, you know, we're not opposed to weird here. I mean, it works. Alright, so last one before all the stretching. And remember, you gotta do the stretching, so you're not done yet. Is also a breakdancing exercise. The reason I'm doing breakdancing is because was it Raiden? No. It was Kung Lao, right? I'm sorry, I'm so bad at his name. For some reason, he's the guy with the hat. He's the character in Mortal Kombat. I can never remember his name. It's Kung Lao, right? Yes, it is. Yes, okay. I don't know what it is. It's just for me, Raiden and Kung Lao just look so similar. And also in the new game, they're always together, so I keep mixing them up. I just lifted myself for a workout. 120 pull-ups, let's go. This looks like something I used to do when I was bored and grounded when I was a child. Yeah. Some of your upper body mobility exercises you've done before have really helped my lower back and shoulders. Still use them every day. That's so great. I'm so happy to hear that, Danny. That's awesome. All right, last exercise, you're gonna be in a plank. Also a breakdance exercise, because Kung Lao does like a breakdancing move and it inspired me to do a little bit of breakdancing today. So you're gonna pull your leg through like this and bring it in. You're gonna do it to the other side. I don't have space for that. Let me just move a little bit. You're gonna bring it through and in. That's 2. Keep going. Bring it through and in. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 2 more, 9, and 10. Really good job. Grab some water, then we're gonna stretch. You guys, for rebuilding knees, I could use those. I'm 2 months into a 14-month recovery. Damn. I'm sorry to hear that, Danny. I hope you listen to your doctors on how to recover, but I do have some good knee exercises. We're not going to do any of them today, but we could definitely soon do a knee workout thing. Again, you know, it's on my YouTube channel as well, SofiaStunts. But it's one of those that pops up once in a while, because I love doing knee. It's important to strengthen our knees, so we do those once in a while. Oh, look on YouTube. It's SofiaStunts. It's in the playlist called, what is it, workouts, I think? Hi, RVD. Thanks for joining. All right, for the flexibility, we're gonna start with working our side splits. Johnny Cage does a middle split, so we're gonna do that after this. But side splits is just such a good thing to be able to do if you're a Mortal Kombat character. Because they are all, not all, but a lot of them are doing some kind of splits at some point in some kind of jump, or, you know, Melina does the handstand split. There's a lot of splits, a lot of side splits, especially if you look closely. Sonya, yes, go. Sorry. Okay, so we're gonna start. I'm actually gonna start with my bad leg. Gonna have one leg up. You know, these are some of my favorite exercises. We do these almost every time, but it's so good for hips. So you're gonna push your hip forward like this. Turn your hip under. We don't wanna be arching our back here. Try to push. Turn your hip underneath to put some weight in. And then we're just gonna wobble back. And then we're just gonna do a couple of these before we settle into it. So you keep your hip turned under. Don't arch your back. If it means you can't go as far down, then that's what it means. As long as it's gonna really stretch through your hip flexor. Sophia Blade. Hello, Mike. Good to see you. Okay, last one that we're gonna stay down. So keep your hip turned in. And stay here. Wherever you want to be. I like to have my hands like this. You can also have them up if you want. Completely up to you. Keep tucking your hip underneath you. Don't release it. But still try to see if you can melt a little bit further into your hip. Keep breathing. All right, really good job. You put your weight back now. Flex your front leg, and then slowly try to put your weight forward wherever you need to stop because it's stretching too much. That's where you stop. I want you to try to see if you can push your lower body down towards, or your lower abs is what I mean, down towards your upper thigh instead of your head down. Try to push your abs down to your thigh. Just got in from a bike ride. Should I get out for a short run, then eat? Or eat and then get on the bike at 2300 for some short bike races? Oh, God, I don't know. That's up to you. I don't know. I personally wouldn't eat first, since it seems like it's gonna be quite hard. But, if you're really hungry, I would. Really good job. Now, I want you to bend that front leg. Go a little bit out to the side. Have your toes pointed out. Put your hip down, just like we did. But it's more right straight in the middle. Then I want you to try to see if you can put your elbows in. And find a good stretch through your hip here. Keep trying to push your hip downward. Good job. Now I want you to slightly push out. See, I'm rolling onto the side of my foot. I'm not letting it relax. Then we're gonna roll our ankle. We don't want that. Keep it straight with your leg and just slightly push to feel a really good stretch through your butt and your hips here. All right, really, really good job. Now it's time to try to go into the side split. And yes, it's hard, but we gotta try it. Otherwise, we'll never learn it, okay? So you bring your foot straight in front of your hip. Oh my God, Cosmic! You bring your foot right in front of your hip, completely straight. You slowly move your toes further forward. If you can grab the floor, even better. A little bit more safe that way. And then you slowly inch your way. If you need to move your back foot back, you do that. Inch your way as far down as you can. And then now, I'm gonna count down 15. So 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Really good job. Slowly raise yourself up and bring your leg in. And then just sit for a little second just to relax everything. Hey guys, good to see you. Hate you in a good way. That makes me happy, Johnny. ER calling, love that. How are they calling you, or how are the ER calling you? I've never heard of that. They knew there was an emergency happening, so they called you in advance. It's kind of annoying to me it's not straight, this one. What happened? How is it not straight? It's because I put it on like this, I guess. This one looks straight. It hurts for you? Trust me, it hurts for me too. Don't worry. It's not painless for me. It hurts for me too. I'm good at not letting it show. Because I do it a lot. So I'm kind of used to the pain. All right, other side. Other leg comes up. Nice and straight with your hip. Turn your hip in. Slowly melt down. And push up. Just a couple times here. Damn it, time's running away from us. We are gonna do the split. All right, stay down. Keep turning your hip inward. Nice deep breaths. Keep breathing. Feel the pain. Push back now, flex it. Try to see if you can push your abs down towards the top of your thigh. See how far you can go down while keeping your foot actively flexed. We don't want to relax it. Actively flex it. Good job. It does hurt. It does hurt, but don't worry. You're gonna feel good about it at some point. Okay, now slowly move your foot out to the side, slightly pointed outward. Slowly put your hands or elbows in if possible, Or if you can't get your elbows in, just try to see how far down you can go with your upper body. Like that. Breathing into it. Good job. Now come up onto your hands, slightly push out on your knee. Open up your hip a little bit more. Keep breathing. Really good job. Bring your leg in. Now time for that side split again. So slowly move your toes forward. Put your hands in if you need to. Put your legs back. And then we're just going to hold it here. 15 seconds. So 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Slowly pick yourself up. You did amazing. Relax your hip for a second. You're doing great. Your time is running away from us. So we're just going to quickly do this one, hip opener, butterfly. Look at the natty arms on her. Yeah! We love some natty arms, don't we? Slowly open up your hips. Thank you for the pets, Billy. You're very kind. Many, many hugs. So much air in my face. Really good job. Now straighten your legs out to the side. So we're not gonna get to do the full Johnny Cage split, but if that's fine, I don't think a lot of people in chat or a lot of people can do that. So it's fine. We don't need to do the full thing. We're just gonna do this exercise to get close to it at least. So you're just gonna wobble. It's gonna work you towards the Johnny Cage split. Wobbling forward. Just get on my back and I'll do it. You can do anything once is what I like to say. Or my friend liked to say it and now I like to say it. Then you slowly bring your hands as far forward as you possibly can. And then we just relax wherever you're at. Keep breathing into the pain. Breathe into the pain. All right, really good job. Bring yourself up. She looks like a superhero with her underwear clothes. I always do, Max. But yes, it does add to it. It does add to it. All right, really good job, guys. That has to be the end because I have a little bit of a schedule going on with my life right now. So I need to end it now. Bring your legs together. But I do recommend that if you have the time to just stretch your shoulders, just 5 minutes shoulder stretch, because we didn't get to do that at all here at the end, but it's important because we have been working our shoulders and our back a little bit. So hi Torg, you're coming in right at the end. It's good to see you though. You're gonna feel it out of doing it. Yep, that's a perfect stretch then. That it works by just looking at it. Isn't that great? Thanks for Grace Jane. It was great having you here. Thank you for joining me for this ultimate Mortal Kombat workout. I hope you enjoyed it. I think it's so much fun to do these themed workouts. Of course, we can't do that every week, or I would be going insane because there would be too much work. But I like to do it once in a while. You know, we're most likely gonna have a Halloween workout as well themed. We had a Christmas one last year. I think we're gonna do a Christmas one again this year and just do a bunch of different ones. It's a lot of fun, you know? Maybe we can have some based on other games or other things or movies or something. You know, we've done a Black Widow one before, a Marvel one, so that was fun. So a bunch of things.